guys. So today I'm going to be doing my November favorites. I know I'm a little bit late and I apologize for that. Yeah, it's just like finals and I have a lot of projects and exams due. And I took a little bit of time out from studying to film this video. Also, before I get started, I just wanted to ask you guys, I have a few days off this coming week from school and from work, and I just wanted to know if you guys had any requests that you guys wanted to see. I was thinking maybe like some tag videos or some looks or like tutorials or anything like that. If you have any ideas of stuff that you want to see, please leave them down below for me so that I can do those since I have some extra time. And I also wanted to run by you guys. I kind of wanted to get a public Snapchat. Right now I just do it with my friends and everything, but I kind of thought it'd be fun to do a public one. So if you guys are interested in that, let me know about that too and I can do that. I just kind of wanted to see how many of you guys would actually be interested in it. I'm gonna go ahead and jump in though to my favorites. So I will start with makeup and then I have some like random stuff at the end, including some like fashion stuff. So for lip product, the first one is the one I'm wearing, and this is the Maybelline Espresso Exposed by Maybelline. I have three by Maybelline, actually. But this is the one that I'm wearing, and I just absolutely love it. It's a really dark, plummy burgundy color. I'll go ahead and swatch them all for you guys. So that is that one. It's very dark and rich, and it's not matte like the other two that I'm going to show you guys are. And then this one is Divine Wine by Maybelline from the MAC collection. I know this has been talked about so much, but there's a reason it's been talked about so much. It's just so gorgeous, you guys. Literally, I will not lie to you. Every time I wear this, I get compliments on this color, and it's usually from guys, which I find really funny because usually guys can be like not that into dark lips on girls, but I always get compliments when I wear this one. So that is that one, and it's just a very gorgeous matte red, darker kind of red color, but not too dark. And it's just like perfect for the holidays and this time of year. And then this one is Touch of Spice, which has also been talked about a ton. And when I first saw this color and people talking about it, I didn't really think it was for me. This is literally the perfect like mauve-y, nude tan color, that color that's just really really in this year that Kylie Jenner has made famous. This is like the perfect one for my skin tone. There is Espresso Exposed, Divine Wine, and Touch of Spice. By the way, you guys, I'm wearing my hair straight, which I hate, but I just didn't feel like curling it, but I hate my hair straight. It's just like And then this one is from BH Cosmetics. I actually did a look using this color a few videos back. I will link down below. And it was one of my favorite looks that I've ever created. I think it came out really, really well. And this was the color I was using. It's Moody Merlot from BH Cosmetics. And it's just a really pretty dark red color. It actually looks very similar to Divine Wine when it's swatched. It's just not matte. Moody Merlot from BH Cosmetics. So another lip product I wanted to mention was the Vaseline Lip Therapy. I feel like I say Vaseline with a Z. Vaseline. I think it's just when I'm saying it like very quickly, it just comes out like that. It protects dry, chapped lips is what it says. I picked this up because I was suffering from really, really dry lips. I guess just with the change of weather, my lips just started to get so dry and chapped and nothing was working. And so I decided to pick this up just kind of randomly on a whim. And I love it. It literally helped like my lips improve within like 2 days. They were so much better. So now I wear this every single night and it's just helped so much. Like I can't recommend this enough. I also wanted to give a quick shout out to Diva Beauty Brushes because I've been obsessed with their brushes, you guys. I mentioned them in my fall makeup look video and I love all of the ones that I got, but I did want to mention three that were my favorite. This is the flat angled buffer brush. It is perfect for foundation and it's very similar to the Sigma one that looks exactly like it. I don't even know the number to it, but it's basically the same thing and it's a lot cheaper and it's just so good. This one is the pointed contour brush and I love this for setting my under eye concealer. So soft and doesn't shed. None of these brushes shed. Really, really good. And then this one is the SO6 Taper Blender and I love this, you guys, for putting color into my crease and blending it out. It's just awesome. Great, 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 great eye brush. Awesome. So yeah, I will link them down below. You guys check them out if you're looking for some new brushes. A blush I've been loving. This is the blush from Model & Co. in Amaretto Sunset. I was wearing this in the look that I posted also. It is a gorgeous kind of darker, I don't even know how to describe it, like darker wine kind of color. It's just so pretty. I'm wearing it today and I don't know if you guys can see it very well. Yeah, I just really, really love it. I think it's gorgeous. And yeah, if you guys want to see this in action, definitely check out that video. For nail polish, I have two favorites. The first one is OPI Visions of Love. I think this might be from the holiday collection. It's a really pretty dark burgundy color. I think I have like a million colors just like this. But this one I like because it has a little hint of brown in it. It doesn't need many coats to look opaque, and it's just, this is like right up my alley for this time of year and for nail polish. I just really gravitate towards these colors. And this one's a little bit different. This one's called First Class Desires. I have no idea what collection this is from, or if it's not available anymore, or if it's permanent. I do not keep up with OPI collections at all anymore. I used to be very, very invested in them. This one I do really like though. It is a kind of like granite green color, if that makes sense. A candle this month I've been loving is the Sweet Cinnamon Pumpkin from Bath & Body Works. I am obsessed with this, you guys. I'm pretty picky when it comes to, I don't know, candle scents for some reason. And so whenever I go to Bath & Body Works and smell all of them, I usually get really overwhelmed and they just all smell like too sweet, too much like food. I'm not that into them. So a lot of Bath & Body Works candles smell like that, and when I smelled this one, it didn't smell like that. It smells very fall, and there's definitely a lot of cinnamon in there, but it's so good. It's just the perfect fall candle, I think. So I've been loving burning this one. Chester is literally knocking all of the ornaments off the tree right now. I can hear him downstairs. For fashion, I wanted to mention these shoes because I have been obsessed with these shoes, you guys. These are from Target. I mentioned these in a haul recently, and they're just a really chunky booty. They're so, so comfortable. I feel like they look really dirty right now. I just love them. They literally go with every single outfit. They dress it up, but they're also kind of casual. They don't look like too dressy, which I like. And I've just been wearing them a ton and highly recommend them. And then my last favorite is a movie I wanted to mention because it's the holiday season. I've been watching a ton of Christmas movies. I just watched Christmas with the Cranks on Netflix, which is a really good one. I recommend that one too. But this one I wanted to mention because it's just, I don't know, this is like one of my favorite holiday movies, Love Actually. If you guys haven't seen this yet, I really recommend it. It's just one of those feel-good movies, and it's just a really great Christmas movie. It's just really good. So wanted to mention that. And yeah, those were all of my favorites for the month of November. I hope you guys liked this video. Again, let me know what you guys want to see. I was thinking of doing a get ready with me. That's the next thing I really want to film, like a morning routine. So let me know what you guys want to see. If you'd like to see that, definitely let me know about the Snapchat. And yeah, I think that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next video. Bye.